Hello, I'm Dr. Annadale, and I teach philosophy at Mount St. Mary's University in Emmitsburg, Maryland. Students often make a crucial mistake when they start thinking about logical arguments. They assume that a bad argument disproves its conclusion. But this is not true. That's not the way arguments work. In this video, I will show you why it's not true and give you some ways of remembering this in case it comes up on an exam or in an argument. First, we should remember what an argument is for. An argument proves a conclusion. We use argument only when there is some doubt about whether the conclusion is true or false. A good argument proves its conclusion is true. It takes you from a state of being in doubt about the conclusion to a state of knowing that the conclusion is true. So what does a bad argument do? Now you might think good argument proves that something is true, so a bad argument must prove that something is false. But this is wrong. That's not the way arguments work. The truth is, a bad argument proves nothing about its conclusion. It leaves you just as much in doubt about the conclusion as you were before. An argument is a proving machine. It's a machine in language designed to prove that the conclusion is true. So a good argument is a good proving machine. It does its job well, and it proves the conclusion. A bad argument is a broken proving machine. It doesn't do the job that it was designed for. So compare it to my vacuum cleaner. When my vacuum cleaner works well, it sucks up dirt. When it breaks, say a belt inside of it breaks, it doesn't start spraying dirt out all over the place, it just fails to work at all. Or compare it to my car. When my car works the way it should, it takes me toward where I want to go. But when my car breaks, it doesn't take me away from where I want to go, it just leaves me right where I am. So a bad argument proves nothing. How can you remember this? First, remember the machine metaphor. An argument is a machine, and a bad argument is like a broken machine which does no work. Second, think of it this way. When you are in doubt about the conclusion, it's like you are in a deep pit. When I give you a good argument for the conclusion, it's like I've given you a ladder to climb up out of the pit. You use my argument to escape from ignorance. But if I give you a broken ladder, or one that's too short, you're stuck in the pit, same as before. The pit doesn't get deeper, you just don't get out. Third, think of a religious or political belief that you hold very strongly, something important that you are convinced is true. Chances are that there's someone out there in the world who believes the exact same thing as you, but for stupid reasons, or on the basis of bad reasoning or bigotry. That person's bad argument doesn't make your shared belief false, or even likely to be false. His bad argument just shows that he doesn't use his mind the right way in forming his beliefs. He might have just lucked into believing something true. So that's my primer on why bad arguments don't disprove their conclusions, and how you can remember it. Thank you for watching today. Goodbye.